Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is Wallenstein back with Rome 2 Total War. We last left off basically preparing ourselves for a conflict in the east. We've built up Roma. We've fortified other areas of our empire, and we've been building up armies, particularly in this area, mainly because our attention is needed east, I think, very soon. Sooner rather than later. Because as you can see, several of our allies are kind of forcing our hand. We have the Egyptians that are making inroads into southern Mesopotamia and into modern-day Iran. Rhodes is constantly at war with Armenia, and what I was hoping would pay off as kind of a buffer. The nomadic Dahe are now wiped out, and Parthia has actually grown in strength considerably. From a couple of provinces in Parthia here to now a pretty formidable sized kingdom. And considering it's this late in the game, my concerns are this, that the Parthians have the technology to have medium tier and upper tier units, as well as having something that I and my armies have a major disadvantage of, and that is cavalry. And not just any cavalry, missile cavalry in particular. Now you might be saying to yourself, oh, Wallenstein, your armies are pretty good, you have pretty good units, you can take use your advantage in infantry, but my thing is I always tend to do very poorly against missile cavalry. Unless, of course, I use missiles against them as well. So what I'm hoping to do, maybe, I've done some little thinking and planning in between recordings. So what I might do is maybe recruit, I have plenty of gold to recruit mercenaries, so I think that's what I might do. I might go down here into Mesopotamia, see what kind of different eastern mercenaries I can conjure up. As you can see, I've already had some luck here getting some hoplites and Rhodian slingers. I might even be able to move and bolster some of my other forces, my current forces, with some other types of units, although because horse skirmishers, they're okay, they're not the greatest tier. Let's see, that hasn't changed. Let me just hit the space bar, so we're moving a little quick here. See, now I can actually recruit. Some falksmen and some spear horsemen. Well, the Dacians aren't that, you know, like it says in the description, not that well known for cavalry, so I might just pass on that. We'll keep moving the rest through here. So that's, I think, what I'm going to be doing is just building up my forces, maintaining this group right here, kind of to deter the Armenians. Because it looks like Rhodes will not last long. It looks like they might lose a lot of their land, at least Edessa and Hatra. They'll be forced back to Tarsus and Antioch, which they'll be able to hold, I think, now, especially that they're moving reinforcements up. But that be as it may, I think the Cold War between our empire and the Eastern kingdoms and factions are going to reach a boiling point very soon. It's either that, or I could play off my allies losing territory and gaining that territory that they've lost. Like I said last episode, I would like to have Trapezos. I mean, it's my capital province, for gosh sakes. I'd like to have control of it and issue edicts from it. I would like to have Caucasia as well, even though it's not, I don't totally need it. It would make my borders here a little more defendable. And at the same time, if possible, But I know both of these cities are walled. I could take Sicilia or Mesopotamia or any of these factions here, or take advantage just of maybe even the Egyptian is down here. Now, my main concern, though, is what the Parthians will do, because we're in a non-aggression pact with the Parthians. However, they're allied with the Armenians and basically all the other eastern factions, with the exception of the Arachrosia, which they're at war with right now. So I'm hoping I can move quickly against the Armenians enough that the Parthians, even if they do break their non-aggression pact and go to war with me, I'll have enough time to defend my borders in Scythia. So that being said, we're going to be doing a lot of preparing for war. As I say that, do I want Tarentine cavalry? Well, I definitely maybe want another veteran hoplite unit. To have three there. And then do I want Tarentine cavalry? They're missile damage, so why not? Like I said, I can afford it. I got another Rhodian slinger. Maybe what I can do. Is maybe what I'll do is I'll move south.
Is that all, my lord?
Persian cavalry. They're pretty decent. Why the hell not? What I might even do, since I have military access, I might go down into Egypt and maybe even to the heartland of Egypt, Alexandria, and maybe get some unique Egyptian mercenaries. Which would be nice, I think. That being said, where's the rest of my armies? Looking pretty good, I think. That's the other thing, is food. We need to upgrade. That will give us minus food. Do that, I think. That's better. And we control that entire province, so I'm not too worried about not gaining a majority Hellenic cultural influence, maybe. We'll do that. That'll be offset and give us a boost to research as well. And meanwhile, we're doing okay in Rome. We'll be able to Hellenize that area very soon. All right, where is my army? Third army. These guys. So moving those guys east, what I hope to do is maybe bring these guys over. Back over to Scythia and have them kind of just keep watch there for the time being. What I'm hoping, And actually, I have spies. I almost was going to complete my turn without moving my spies over. That is my army, yes, that Pontic army. Oh yes, I definitely want to move those guys out. Move these guys that way. Where are they? Start moving the rest of these peeps towards the east. That's pretty much all we can do now.
How may I serve Pontus?
We're not going to have much use of our navy. If and only if. Oh, we actually could bring it in to take Trapezos. So maybe that's what I'll do. I will build up my navy in Trapezos. Bowie. Bowie and the Budini. Kind of in a tussle right now. I'm having a feeling that the Bowie should win. I'll be surprised if the Budini start making a lot of progress there. So that's what I'll do, I think. Are any decent ships I can recruit? Not really. Get a couple. Come on. Yeah, I don't think I need a mercenary fleet. I mean, truthfully, if war happens, I can take my two armies here, take Mesteta, or at least defend against the Armenian armies that might come. My weak spot, I think, is Gabala. And once they take that, they can just march on up through Scythia. So maybe what I'll do is maybe I'll pull... I basically need to keep the Armenian armies occupied, while at the same time making sure the Parthians don't sneak in through Scythia and start tearing up my kingdom. Persians. Yeah. Well, we didn't even change our turn yet. Spartans still hold their lonely. They do keep their isolationist. Isolationism. Excuse me. True in this playthrough. I think we're pretty much good. There's nothing else we can do, so we'll end our turn. I just hope that in these next few turns, as I'm busy preparing for war and moving my armies east, building them up, that none of the eastern factions...
Join your mighty strength with ours!
None of the eastern factions declare war against me, or I get dragged into a war earlier than I would like.
I speak as the sword cuts, direct to the bone of the matter. Listen, and possibly give agreement.
No, I don't want a satrapy. As much as you were useful earlier in my campaigns, I'll let the Bowie deal with you as they wish. I don't want to create a rift in
we
my north.
We would be forever in your debt if you ordered your worthy generals to act against these monsters.
Not yet, Rhodes.
I am saddened that Athena has not given you wisdom.
I will be honest. I seek coin as token of your good and continued friendship.
I wouldn't pay even my closest allies that much. Get out. Okay, let's maybe see if we can get one more Persian cavalry. Yes. Meanwhile, we'll move into Antioch. Elephants. And they're armored elephants too. Ooh, that's tough. I mean, there's Syrian archers too. Jeez, what do I want to do? Do I want to recruit both of them? Why not? This could be a very effective force indeed. Now the hoplites don't have, veteran hoplites don't have square formation, but that's fine. Then maybe I can head south. That army's turning out pretty nicely, actually. Like most mercenaries, they can be expendable. I won't be too worried about losing them, because they'll be a better long-term benefit.
At your command.
Even if they go down.
In Apollo's footsteps. How can I serve you?
You can serve me by heading east, my friend. Have my sword, and you have my bow and my axe. I mean, truthfully, I'm turning into a kind of multicultural force, so I think I do have some axes in here. Or maybe no, I don't. Actually, I don't. The sentinel of Hyperion. Yeah, see, they're done. The only reason they create a satrapy with me is because they knew they were going to be done.
On the move, my lord. My lord. Advance. Waiting for more orders.
What does this army make up? Yeah, I'll move them. In Scythia, I'll move these guys down as well.
Journey completed,
sir.
My lord.
Ravaging chimeras, I mean, and these guys, what do these guys have? Oh, yeah. I could use Persephone's favorites as a meat shield army because they have so many Eastern spearmen. That's what I think I'll do. In the meantime, I will keep an eye out on our foodstuffs to make sure desperately getting low. Things are on the up and up, it looks like. I'll leave that there for now. Yeah. So I think we're pretty much fine there. Not much more we can do. So I will end my turn. See what everyone else does. I mean, the Rhodians will definitely be a great help. The Rhodian faction, I mean, will definitely be a great help in my campaign. They might bear the brunt of the Armenian assault. The Macedonians might even come to my aid, as well as the Egyptians. And even the Seleucids here might take a stab at regaining their lost empire. Of gold.
A lump sum would ensure his good opinion.
Not yet. All right, let's continue moving south. Huh? I don't have a military pact with them? Well, we'll fix that.
You honor me with your worthy presence. I am... In the name of the Lord of the Two Egypts, strength and health be...
Whoops. My lord. And more of those. So let's... Yeah, Seleucids are building up their forces. Bring them to dock there.
By sea or by mountain, sire.
Yeah, we can't do much recruiting there, but we'll just leave them there as a nice little balance force. Rhodes is falling back, it looks like. Looks like they'll lose Hatra, as well as have a slave revolt. Oh no, that's not a slave, that's Parthava. They got wiped out. Doing that, we can bring the rest of our boys over. What mercenaries can we get here? Come on. Ooh, these are some nice ones. Thracian warriors. Mercenary Thracian cavalry. Nice. Nice. Yes, we're moving you guys east. Almost into Scythia. We're moving all our guys east. We're moving you particularly into Parthia. Scythia. Get your territory straight, Wallenstein. Let's see. Continue moving everybody over. It's a shame my agents can't move as quickly as my armies.
I'm a going.
All right, we're good there. Can't do any more recruiting. Same old. That's right, we have this building as well. And in two turns, what are we researching? More wealth. What did I want to do last time? Yes, land reclamation. That's what I wanted to do. Ooh, where's that Armenian Navy going? There's one thing I'm gonna be petrified of, is an Armenian army roaming through the Black Sea, unchecked. Oh, crap. Some of my generals have died. Antipathies. All right, Agapios. Yeah. Sparta. So Sparta's gotten dragged in, so maybe they'll get some territory of their own. Let's see what progress. Egyptians look like they're going to take Seleucia. Yeah, oh my god. Egyptians are making a nice little push from the looks of it in that area. Camel archers. I mean, can we use? They're not that powerful, I don't think. Maybe I should use them. Let's take a look in Egypt first, see what units we can get. It's only another turn away. Seleucids are making a beachhead from the looks of it. Look like they'll be pushing ever forward. Alright, what can we recruit? Nothing! What? Nonsense. There we go. That's what I'd like to see. Recruiting ships. All right, build them up. Then maybe just have the onager. Onagers to fill it out. Alright, so we're looking pretty good, I think. Did I move the rest of these guys? Can they be moved? Oh, yes, they can. Back in native lands, boys. Back in your homeland. I feel stronger already. Guys north too. Move you to Parthava. Definitely move you guys south because there'll be all the walled cities down there. They're lagging ever slowly behind. Do is have them guy. Pretty much discovered everything down there. All right. Yeah, we'll keep plowing forward. Let's just move him. Can't go that far, I guess. Or that far. Yeah, that's as far as he can go. That's fine. End our turn again. Now we are coming to the 25. Quickly approaching the 25 turn mark. We have 30 turns left, I think, now, before the game actually ends. So I'll have to make it worth it, especially if I want to take that.
The gods weep when men battle.
Not yet. Not yet. In two more turns, I shall be ready.
My people do not like luxury, but money is needed. I ask humbly that you give us some.
Yes. I'm gonna need all the help I can get moving into the east.
It is a terrible thing.
Not yet, Rhodes. Hold on a little longer. Temple design. Actually, that gives me... Yes, construction cost bonus there. So we can do land reclamation in 6 turns. How are we looking? How's Anacrosia? They're slowly getting pushed back. Parthia's growing ever stronger. Actually, I could do that to check diplomacy. No, maybe I can't. Alright, so that war with Egypt's looking at blah blah. They're military allies with Armenia. And we are in a non-aggression pact, if I recall.
You have yes. My attention. Now, do not try to charm with the Lord.
Huh. Strange. They lost that. Nos Knossos. They're destined to take that, aren't they? Well, once they move in and Armenia takes it, we might have our hand forced here. Put you in normal stance. Start moving you in. Actually, no, what am I doing? Move you there. You can recruit your ships and then have a nice swift ride into. Now let's find out what mercenaries we can get.
At your command, to the pillars of Heracles, if you wish.
Leopard warriors. Maybe I'll go with the camels. The Eastern Mercenary Army, that is. is approaching quickly. The drums. The drums. The drums in the deep. That's right, where are these guys at? Now, hopefully, with Parthia being occupied with Aracrosia, I can start a war early. Before my two armies actually get to Akhtal. Now what do I want? Do I want them to take Akhtal? Because what do I have there? That's my farm sources, so I really can't lose that, or else I'll be screwed. So I might have to go on the offensive in Parthia. I might have to quickly take Kath. Maybe what we'll do. Oop, nope, recruit an agent. That's what I want. Recruit a dignitary. Ibelus. I'll have them start moving east. Alright, speaking of the rest of my diplomatic boys. That's right, we got you too. Oh, you already moved. You already made your move. Where's the rest of my armies? Got a navy there, a diplomat there. One, two, three, four. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. But we can do 2 now. He's there. Start building up these guys' forces. See what Trapezus does in the next couple turns. And as I say that, we'll move our agents so that they're already moving. Yeah. So we'll end our turn. See what happens. See what happens, and I think we might call it a night for this episode.
These people trouble even the gods.
That's on you, my friends. Seems like you're handling them pretty well.
You are strong and wise, and yet I wonder
who?
Why you stand aside from this war. I beg you, fight!
I got other matters to attend to right now. I would have loved to, but matters in the east are forcing my attention there. All right, let's see. What do we got? What do we got? Macedonians have already joined the conflict. Case. Build up that fleet. Move these guys to the border. We might as well go to war against Knossos. Maybe that's what we can do. We can take two birds out with one stone, because they're not allied with anyone. If I move my navy out... I can risk it. We will take our navy, take out Knossos. That's the last thing I want, is them having a foothold in Trapezus. I want this province. The province shall be mine. So I think we'll leave it there for now. The drums of war are beating ever louder now. It looks like war in the east will soon begin. So, with that being said, next time we'll open up our war with the East. We'll push out. Towards the East. Let me just take a look. Keep it there for now, so I think we'll leave it there for now. Next time, we will be at war again. I know I sound like a warmongering person, but this is total war after all. It's the object of the game. So, with that being said, thanks all for watching, and I will see you all next time.